Now let's take a look at the different components of the Panduit Fault Managed Power System, how it works, and what happens when a fault occurs. Again, if you picture with me the head end of your building, this rack has a transmitter chassis. In the back of this chassis, we have a single power supply unit. That power supply unit is basically can take anywhere from 120 volt or a single phase 208 volt. It takes that AC power and converts it to high voltage DC. In the front here, we have four transmitter modules and the network management card. The transmitter modules are taking that high voltage DC from the power supply unit and then pulsing it on and off. This is our way of doing class 4 and detecting for faults. So each one of these transmitter modules is constantly looking for the 7 faults that are in the UL1400-1 standard. Once a fault occurs, it only occurs in that one channel. That channel turns off. If the fault clears, that channel recognizes that. It's self-healing, so it'll just turn itself back on. So we have four transmitter modules that are represented also in this user interface. This is the user interface that's basically connected from our network management card. Now remember, you can access this through an IP address, or you can pull data out of this and control it through SNMP version 2, version 3, or you can use REST API protocols. So if we look at this user interface, it's showing us the status of the system. Right now, I have one power supply unit in the back. I have transmitter modules 1 and 2 connected to a receiver that's powering our DAS radio and lights. I have transmitter modules 8 and 9 connected to our second receiver, which is powering our PoE switch. We can, through this user interface, get a lot of monitoring data, such as temperature, voltage, current, how much power is being consumed, how much capacity we have left. So for example, I can go to the capacity screen here and I can see every component of our system, how much power is being used, and how much capacity I still have left. I can go to a power supply unit, a transmitter, or even the receiver to be able to tell how much voltage is coming in, how much voltage is coming out, how much current is being consumed, what the temperature is. A very interesting feature of the Panduit Fault Managed Power System is not just the monitoring, but also the ability to control. So if you want to troubleshoot a device at the edge by simply power cycling it, you can do that remotely, whether by logging into the user interface or by using SNMP traps. So for example, if I'm going to go to the control and manage screen here and go to our receivers, and I'm going to turn off our receiver that's powering the DAS radios and lights for us. So I simply go here, disable it, and you can see the lights and the DAS radio go off instantly. I can come back and turn that on, and there you go. This can be done remotely to troubleshoot any issues in the field. The other big benefit of fault managed power is the centralized nature. Aside from the fact that it's class 4, it allows it to be a low voltage installation. You can run it in the same pathway as your fiber. Doesn't have to be running in conduit. These are all benefits from a day one installation perspective. But when you think about the centralized power architecture now, this allows you to centrally back up your system with a single UPS. So if you had a number of devices at the edge, like a number of PoE switches at the edge, and you want to back them up, before, you may have to put a UPS next to each switch. Now you can have one central UPS connected to our transmitter chassis, and now every switch that's connected to that is backed up centrally. You also have now metering, monitoring, and control capabilities from one central location. Now let's take a look at how the system behaves when a fault occurs. Going back to the screen here, I'm gonna focus more on transmitter modules 1 and 2. Which are right here. And those are connected to a class 4 cable in the back. So two pairs of copper cable running out to our receiver. And in that path, we're introducing one fault for each of these transmitter modules. One of the transmitter modules connected to a fire hazard, which is, we're showing you one of the 5 different faults that are in the standard. And the second transmitter module is connected to a shock hazard, which is represents one of the 2 faults that are in the standard. And we're showing you through this screen here what the actual shape of the current that's coming out of these channels. Each one of these channels is basically outputting this high voltage DC that is being pulsed on and off. Again, these 2 channels are powering our receiver, which is powering the lights and the DAS radio for us. So now I'm going to introduce one of the faults by simply hitting one of these buttons, introduce the shock hazard. You can see instantly that channel turned off. You can also see that it went red and it blinked red here. It actually did it so quickly. It knows that that fault is not there anymore. It takes it a few seconds and it will just restart itself automatically. Now notice that the lights and the DAS radio are still on because we still had a second channel running. So we had enough capacity from that second channel to power the receiver, which powers the lights and the radio for us. You can already see that that channel came back online and it's already now sharing the load with that first transmitter module channel. Now what I'm going to do is actually introduce a fault to both of these channels to see how the system behaves. I'm going to introduce a fire hazard fault and a shock hazard fault. If I go quickly here, you can see the LEDs blinking red. You can see the transmitter modules went red. You can even see the receiver went red. That basically means it's a major fault, you lost power. The system again, or these channels are self-healing. They already know that the fault is not there anymore. So it takes them a few seconds and you should be able to start seeing the channels come back online in this screen. Now you can see transmitter module 1 and 2 channels are back online. It takes a few seconds to push that pulse current or class 4 power out to our receiver. Once the receiver receives that class 4 power, it takes a few seconds for the capacitor to charge up and then it turns back on automatically. And as you can see, the lights and the DAS radio are back online. This now kind of represents and concludes to you how the Panduit fault managed power system works, the different components, the benefits that you get, the low voltage installation while being able to push a lot more power over long distance safely by running it in the same pathway as your fiber. And you have the centralized benefits. You can centrally back up your power distribution with a single UPS. You have monitoring and control capabilities that allow you to troubleshoot your system remotely and be able to tell how much power you still have available if you wanted to add a second or a third device to that receiver at the edge. To learn more about Panduit's fault managed power system, visit us at panduit.com/FMPS or contact your local Panduit sales rep.